Major flooding continues across inland New South Wales, and Victoria and Tasmania looks to be impacted by heavy rainfall mid and late this week. But looking at those warnings first, we can see many flood warnings current. It's becoming a repetitive pattern at the moment, right across inland parts of New South Wales. Now, we currently have 6 or 7 rivers in major flooding or may experience major flooding in the coming days, particularly around the communities of Gundagai, Gunnedah, as well as Weewa, Warren, and also through Forbes as well as we get into tomorrow. So if you live in this part of the world or know someone that does, just make sure you continue to stay updated with the latest forecast and warnings, as even though the rain has stopped, water will continue to move downstream as these flood peaks move further down. Now, looking into the week ahead, unfortunately, we have another rain system on the way across much of southeastern Australia. So today and tomorrow, looking quite dry across many of our flood-affected areas of New South Wales, as well as Tasmania, Victoria, and southern Queensland. Now, as we move into Wednesday, we'll start to see this next weather system move in, and that's going to tap into some tropical moisture coming in from the Indian Ocean and then eventually down in from the Coral Sea, bringing widespread rain and thunderstorm activity to South Australia, and then Victoria, New South Wales, and Tasmania on Wednesday and into Thursday. Now, Thursday, we could see some pretty heavy falls on and north of the ranges in Victoria, including Melbourne area as well as many areas across northern and western parts of Tasmania, southwestern parts of New South Wales, and possibly the eastern border districts of South Australia. And then we'll see that system move into our major flood-affected areas on Friday into early Saturday, but thankfully it'll move through very quickly with only light to moderate falls expected there. Now, looking at the total rainfall for the coming week, we can see some light showers in Tassie today and tomorrow, but really pretty dry until we get to around that Wednesday timeframe. Then we're going to see that rainfall really ramp up Wednesday and Thursday with a band of widespread at least 25 to 40 millimetres extending through inland parts of South Australia and much of New South Wales, Victoria and Tasmania. And then as we move into the latter part of the week, we can see widespread 50 to 100 millimetres across parts of southern New South Wales, Victoria and much of Tasmania. And this could lead to moderate to possibly major riverine flooding, particularly for areas in northern Victoria and possibly northern Tasmania as well. So we'll definitely need to be on the lookout for that. And looking at a closer look at that rainfall that's going to impact Victoria and Tasmania in the coming days, yeah, our concern really is shifting towards southern New South Wales, much of northern Victoria, and also northern Tasmania as well, as we could see these widespread falls of 50 to 100 millimetres, with isolated falls up to 150 millimetres possible in these areas. So if you live in this part of the world and in New South Wales, or know someone that does, in the coming days, make sure you stay up to date with the latest forecasts and warnings via our website, app, and social media. Listen to all advice from emergency services on flood-affected rivers, and we'll continue to keep you updated here at the Bureau.